Now, let us see how the Bolsheviks have seized power from the provisional government. So, Lenin has become the leader of Bolshevik party. So, Vladimir Lenin has become the leader of the Bolshevik party. So, this Bolshevik party has demanded immediate and unconditional peace and nationalization of land, banks and factories. And this after the nationalization of land, the land should be redistributed to the poor people and control of the prices. So the Lenin party has means Bolshevik party has demanded for the immediate and unconditional peace, and the next one is control over the prices. And when you come to the nationalization, what they wanted to nationalize means the nationalization of land, and that land should be redistributed to the poor people, and nationalization of the banks, as well as nationalization of the factories. So when these people demanded, so with the Bolshevik party people, they demanded, and with the help of the Soviets, they seized the provisional government in the month of October and November. So the Bolshevik party people, with the help of the Soviets, they seized the government of provisional government. So that was in the month of October and November. So when they were seized the government, immediately they have taken steps of nationalization of land, and the land was redistributed to the poor people, and they wanted to end the war. But the problem is the Bolsheviks could not take the control over the country, because the war was not ended. So, and moreover, instead of ending the war, the civil war was started in the Russia. So what is the civil war here? Means the civil war, the against of, means between the two people. One side is the Bolshevik and Soviets people, and another side is white armies. White armies supported by the Russian monarchy, nothing but Tsar King. Tsar King and his army was called as the white armies. And Tsar side, Tsar Nicholas II side, and even anti-communist also supported. And not only that, even developed nations like allies, Britain, USA, France and Japan, is all together one side, and the Bolsheviks and Soviets, these people were one side. So this war was started in the 1917, and by the 1920, so these all people were defeated. In the 1920, so these all people and Tsar and Tsar supporters were defeated, and ultimately these Bolsheviks people were won. Right, after defeating of this, so Bolsheviks people have divided the nations of Tsar Empire. So the Bolsheviks people were divided the nations of Tsar Empire, and they have given independence to them. They wanted to, if they want to separate from the Tsar Empire, they can separate it and they can get the independence. So that is what they did. And afterwards, after getting the independence also, these all the nations of Russia, so they were joined as a USSR. So they were joined in a USSR. So which is called as a Union of Soviet Socialist Republics. So this all thing was happened in a 1922. Means the USSR was formed in a 1922. And so after the formation of the Bolshevik party, so then there were some experiments were done. So what kind of experiments? So the Russia, the people, they wanted to see where the exploiters like a feudal lords and the kings and the capitalists all should be removed. So they wanted to make the experiment, like exploiters should be removed, like a feudal lords and kings and capitalists should be removed, and the equality should be brought. So inequality should be removed. So inequality should be removed based on a gender or birth or like a literacy. So this all should be removed. So all should be equal. So that is what they wanted to make in a Russia. So rise of Stalin. After the death of Lenin in 1924, the Joseph Stalin has become leader of Communist Party. The meaning of CP is Communist Party. So rise of Stalin has become a leader after the death of Lenin in 1924. And this person has used his absolute power to control the country, and he tried to end the opposition parties. And not only that, and he means using his undisputed powers with the undisputed powers, he made an economic plan. So that economic plan was used in means implemented in 1928. So that plan was called as a 5-year plan. So the Joseph Stalin has introduced one planned economy, so which is called as a 5-year plan. So it happened in 1928. So in this 5-year plan, he introduced the twin policy system. So what are the twin policies? So what are the twin policy system means? What is twin policy system means? First, industrialization and collectivization of agriculture. So in this twin policy, he wanted to develop the first industrialization and collectivization of agriculture. And now we shall see the impact of revolution. So this revolution which was happened in Russia has inspired all over the world. So the revolution which was happened in the USSR has inspired all over the world. But because these people, USSR people, has tried to bring the equality and the liberation. Even the people who were committed towards the like a communist idea, the people whoever had the communist ideas, they were also trying to improve, they were also trying to bring the equality and liberation in their countries. If you take the example of India, some of the Indian leaders also were inspired, like M.N. Roy and Nehru Tagore. So M.N. Roy and Jawaharlal Nehru and Rabindranath Tagore, they were also attracted towards the socialist ideology of USSR. But they were not agreed with all the ideologies of USSR. Why? Because these people have done some of the violence. So what kind of violence? In the process of suppressing the opposition parties, and there was a lot of human loss. They have killed number of lakhs of people of opposition party people, and they did not encourage the multi-party system, and there was no freedom of expression. So these things were not encouraged by our Indian leaders. So these things were rejected by our Indian leaders, not only Indian leaders and some of other leaders also who wanted to follow the democratic ideology. So based on a revolution of USSR, and the people have before the revolution, the people had a good ideology and they wanted to develop the country, but that all ideals were neglected. So based on this, George Orwell has written one satiric novel. So that novel name is called as a Animal Farm. How the ideals of USSR is suffering in USSR. Sorry, how the ideals of USSR are suffering in this country. So that was written in a Animal Farm story. It's a novel written by the George Orwell.